narrative of Tolkien Beach. You get a good view from here, and if you look back over your shoulder, you can see the harbour back there in the corner of the bay. Also back there, up on the headland, the little white building with the chimney is the Hewer's Hut. It's where they used to keep a lookout for the shoals of fish years ago. The building's thought to date from the 14th century and was probably a hermitage originally. Cream-coloured building further out in the low part of the headland is the old lifeboat house, which has one of the steepest slipways in Britain. And the little white turret-like building on the end of Tower Head is the disused Coast Guard hotel. This is the Barrow Field, named after the Bronze Age burial barrow or tumulus you can see there. Some local chieftain was buried under that mound 3,500 to 4,000 years ago. There were 15 tumuli on this site, but unfortunately the farmer, who was probably after the stone they're largely constructed from, destroyed them back in 1821. Became a tourist resort, it was a busy harbour town. Its fishing industry reached its peak in the mid-1800s when we had 13 fish sellers in the town. There they'd stock the fish down in wooden barrels, ready for export all over Britain and the continent. In those days of sailing ships, cargo vessels would come down from the Bristol Channel ports, South Wales, even Southern Ireland to unload here, rather than risk the treacherous rounding of Land's End. But after the introduction of steamships, the more sheltered deep water harbours on the south coast of Cornwall took over, and the last loads of coal and china clay, for example, handled here by Newquay Harbour, was in 1921. Tourism started with the coming of the railways and the opening in around 1900 of the three big seaside luxury hotels, the Headland Hotel, the Atlantic and Victoria. Their wealthy guests would come down and stay for several weeks at a time. The working man had to wait until after the First World War before he got his week at the seaside, and then invariably travel down by rail and stay in one of the many guest houses that opened up in the town. Two bowling greens, next to it the tennis centre with that green and white inflatable dome you can see there that contains two courts. Straight on under the bridge, down to Trenant Gardens and the lakes in just a moment. But first, we're going to call in here to the zoo.
All this lovely garden on the right is the Crazy Golf. Water World is the swimming pool complex, and that's straight ahead of us up through the car park. I'm just going to pass the zoo entrance along here on the left. We'll be here for 3 or 4 minutes and then we'll head on down to the gardens.